looking for a match, as you know, against Kim So-hee of South Korea. She's made it through to the final at the expense of Ren Dandan of China. And as both athletes make their way to the ring, Juan Marino, you pointed out to me just as we were talking off microphone there that the Russian Anastasia Valieva, she's got a good pedigree coming in.
Representing Tunisia.
I tell you what, she won the Youth Olympic Games, the inaugural Youth Olympic Games in Singapore. I'm going to go out on a limb here. I'm going to say this is going to be a great match. Because I happened to watch a Tunisian fighter early in the day. She was scrappy. She was really getting at it. The Russian is just, she's really coming on strong. Young lady, very talented. I think it's going to be a great match. They match up well together, too.
Well, as they always say, styles make fights. And we look forward to that here because Farhani of Tunisia, well, she's the All-African champion from 2010. A couple of medals in the open circuit in Europe. And she's coming in reasonable form, and she's going to have to be on form because Valieva,
very flexible athlete, very flexible, spins extremely well. She's a sharp young fighter.
And she looks very cool and composed there. Farhani getting ready. And so much of it is about mastering the occasion. You were talking there about the Chinese athlete Ren Dandan. She came into it in the third round. She forgot about her nerves a little bit.
Yeah, I think these two athletes are young enough. They're actually going to be just the opposite. They're going to bring that youth and excitement to this match right from the get-go. So there's no clear favorite, so they're going to be kind of positioning, sparring for dominance, so to control the match, the tone of the match. So it should be really interesting.
Yeah, we look forward to it here as the action gets underway. Our center referee, Abdel Chahibi, calls the two females to action here. Second Finweight semi-final. Not the cagey start that we had in the first one. But
both of these girls, look at these front legs, are just incredible. Fast, accurate, good balance. This is going to be a great match. Look.
Yes, a wonderful back underneath there. Didn't score, but as you rightly called it, one, an explosive start so far.
Yeah, I know the Valieva, her spin kick is really sharp. She, especially for a female athlete, you don't see too many of them throwing those on the counterattacks.
Sure.
And definitely can do it.
I think that's one of the best things of the evolution of Taekwondo is that some of the skills that had been lost a little bit in the power game have now transferred to the spinning and the headshots because of the extra points you can get.
Absolutely. And it's made it more spectator friendly. No matches, no lead is safe, so to speak. So sure. It's really exciting.
Good check in there from Valieva. She takes center ring, the Russian. The blue square, keeping back for Hani there. Almost a headshot there.
Very interesting that the Russian athlete is left-legged and the Tunisian athlete is right-legged, so they're kind of matching up in that open stance. Now we have a switch here. Let's see what happens, see what develops here.
It's great commentary, almost as if we knew they were going to change stance there. Well, that's the insight that we've come to know and love. You switch back to open stance here, trying to draw the opponent in, but in that front-legged style, as you rightly said, jabbing, faking, keeping them at distance, but that looked like a sword.
Yeah, that was a little low quad.
That's the sort of blow over a long day that that's not the first time that's happened today.
Yeah, she's probably had a bunch of them today, so it's just getting a little tender there.
But you know, no guts, no glory, and it is the semi-final. I'm sure Farhani will be back on her feet in a few moments' time. She is 3-0 down. As our doctor comes onto the mat, the two Mexican officials, let's let them do their work.
Watch, the one thing I'll tell you that Villanueva does so, Villanueva does so well, watch, she's going to continue attacking, she's going to continue putting the pressure, she's not going to sit back on the lead, she's just that, she has a lot of gusto, she's really keep going out. She'll initiate the contact.
Straight upstairs, and it was a perfect shot. And that aggression there, she shook off that injury with, as you say, great fighting spirit, but she's signaling to the referee, I think maybe the arm guard is loose, or the glove.
Valieva did something really interesting after that last exchange. Instead of kicking with her front leg and just going to the back side of the head, she actually did a front leg hook kick and tried to go to the front side. Let's see if that gets in there, changing the direction of the kick.
You a fan of the old school one?
No, I, of course, I love the old school fighting. I grew up in that era, but I appreciate what the athletes do nowadays. I know every era has its challenges, so this is exciting.
The dropping in that hook kick, that was the can see some of these shots here, man. Here was the attempted back kick.
The first shot. Face kick. Coach is pulling the card to ask for the video review. I'm sure he's going to look for the 3 points. See if he can pull this match even closer. Wow, what a back and forth match.
Here comes Dennis Ojo up the steps to try and gather the card. French video referee is going to accept the card here from Tahara Fastavor of Israel. So Dennis needs to have a look as they go back. I think there was a definite flinch from Valieva. Either it could have been very close or full contact, but we wait for the pronouncement here. We can have a little sneaky view over the shoulder. There's Thomas of Dartfish. He wouldn't be at a competition if Thomas wasn't here. The man in demand, doing a fine job.
Thomas is, he's great. I mean, he travels all around the world making sure all the video equipment works properly. This one's going to be interesting because it was very close. I couldn't tell exactly, but it looked pretty darn close.
See, oh, the anticipation for Fahani, but
declined.
Not to be, as you say, declined. Match with the scoreboards, unfortunately, just as they, I think they've managed to put the video replay onto the scoreboards. And now they've got it back to 7 points to three. Anastasia Valieva of Russia in prime position. There's another attempted headshot over the shoulder from Tahara. She's pushing it, throwing it back out of the ring. 5 points of a gap. She will take a kill goal here. Valieva.
Ryan is very strong. I mean, this match does not seem like it's out of reach at all.
And you can talk strategy and tactics as well, but this is tactics.
She's lost her quota, she's lost her ability to video replay, so she knows it's in her hands. She knows that she has to just kind of make turn this into a dogfight. And you know, she's been doing that since round one, so.
And it's testament to both the athletes' fitness that they can sustain this, because without the footwork and the faking, these ladies just have to keep kicking and moving the whole time. And to sustain that over such a long day is testament to them and their training and their coaches, but it is still a 5-point gap. Here's the virtual attempt of Valerie. certainly felt it.
You're right, there's some of these injuries coming into play right now. This has to be their fifth match of the day. They've been here since 8 o'clock in the morning. Those bumps and bruises are just, they're just zinging right now.
Yeah, big time. And that'll be one that they'll be feeling tomorrow, but hopefully for Anastasia Valueva, she'll be looking to jump into the final. But Farhani here doesn't have her problems to seek. In the attempt of throwing that kick, she took a heavy landing. Quite a judicious use here of a little break just to get her breath back and just to recover.
Final 18 seconds here. Let's see if Rani can get one or two points back here and just kind of make this match a little closer going into the last round. I like that front leg hook kick against the front leg attack.
Especially in that open stance.
Absolutely.
As you called it, Farhani's got the strength. She's bullying. Just a little bit on the scoreboard. Tahara Katabor of Israel brings to end the second period. That's a nice match.
Well fought. Both these athletes are extremely good. Holloway was unfortunate to get her kick to land. But it's really
good.
Very strong, tough athlete.
There's that hook kick that you've been making mention of. Didn't quite score. Don't rule that out down the stretch. Valueva tries with a shot over the shoulder. And just as you were mentioning, how knowledgeable this Mexican crowd is, this roof is going to come off when BBB comes out.
It's going to be, this may be the loudest I've ever heard a Taekwondo tournament. I mean, this really is going to be something. I was here for the Pan Am Games in 2011, smaller venue. Damien fought there, and it was unbelievable. But I can't, it's not going to match this. This is going to top it.
Well, Damien Villa comes out next against Korea's Cha Tae-moon. But it's all about the 46-kilogram semi-final number two, Anastasia Valueva of Russia. She has a commanding five-point lead, but we know that games can change in an instant. Farhani of Tunisia trying again with that jab front leg. Almost going over the shoulder there of the Russian.
I'm so impressed with both of these, but a little bit more with Anastasia, that her ability to use her front leg, kick so high multiple times, and still maintain her balance. I mean, she's something else.
It's that coordination and composure. She steps around the reverse tunnel kick. That looked like a painful one. But Anastasia quite within her rights to keep kicking to the final bell.
Yeah, those ones, when they connect, they can do a lot of damage because the athlete obviously doesn't see it. There's a lot of momentum of them falling, running into the foot. That can be bad news.
Yep. Seem to remember Steven Lopez against Sebastian Michaud in 2009 when he kicked him like a football.
Absolutely. One of the match. That was the kick that won the match. Yep. 3-0.
It's 8-4 just now because of the Kyungo there against Valueva.
This next minute is going to be a barn burner because you're going to see Farhani is going to come out. She's going to keep going. Hey.
Just the physical intensity just beginning to tell now on Farhani. And Valueva doing the right thing. As much as she's trying to kill time, she's doing it in an aggressive way.
Yes. She's strong. I mean, you see her, she's a little wisp of a woman, you know, but man, you watch her in the ring, she's a terror. She gets out there and she really... Very physical. And I've noticed that from a lot of the Russian athletes. I mean, yeah. Very strong. Their matches seem to be high impact. Not a lot of downtime. I think that's what they do. They wear their opponents down a little bit physically and mentally. Then all of a sudden they break and they're able to get their face shot in and everything just the tides turn so quickly.
Farhani has it all to do here. Tears there. She knows she's on the podium. Does she have anything left to push Anastasia Valueva? She's certainly given all she has into the final minute. Almost walks into a reverse turning kick there from the Russian in red. It's a battle for the centre of the ring, and Anastasia Valueva using that physicality, that dominance. Not too active on the scoreboard, but not drawing the wrath of the referee. Looking busy, keeping Farhani at bay, blocking that front leg of ease.
Absolutely, that's a great point. She's not doing a whole lot on scoreboard, but look how well she fends her off with the front leg. She mixes up defenses and attacks. Not taking any risk with that back leg.
But it has been a valiant effort from Farhani as we approach just the business end of this third round. There's only about 10 seconds left. Farhani looks bereft of ideas, tries to step through back, but good cover from Valueva.
Excellent try. Excellent try. And that's what you want to see. Four-point kick, you go for it again. That's exactly what you want from your athlete. There's a lot to build for her. She's definitely has a bright future. Bronze medal at the World Championships is awesome. I'm sure we'll see plenty more of this athlete.
Yep, Farhani of Tunisia provided us with great warrior spirit and great entertainment, but it is Anastasia Valueva who marches on to the final. She will take on Kim Soo Hee from South Korea. And her physicality, her skill and strength, correct strategy, takes the Russian through to the final. I'll bring you that action in a few moments' time, but coming up next, don't go anywhere.